When we think of main battle tanks today, most armies rely on guns in the 120mm or the 125mm range. The American M1 Abrams uses the 120mm smoothbore Rheinmetall gun, while Soviet and Russian designs like the T-72, T-90, and the modern T-14 Armata all armed with 125mm to a 46 or its successors. These calibres represent the standard balance between firepower, ammunition size, and practicality on modern battlefields. But throughout history, tank designers often experimented with much larger guns, pushing the limits of what tanks could carry. In this video, we focus on the five largest caliber guns ever mounted, on main battle tanks and tank destroyers. We will not include artillery systems or howitzers, as we have published them in another separate video. The Panzerkampfwagen 8 Maus. This German super heavy tank was the heaviest tank ever built. Designed during World War II, it entered service in 1944, though never seeing combat. The Maus was intended as a breakthrough super heavy tank, combining massive armor with unmatched firepower. Its main armament was the 128mm KWK-44 L-55 gun paired with a coaxial 75mm gun for added versatility. It fired heavy 128mm projectiles, weighing about 28 to 28.3 kilograms for both armor-piercing and high-explosive types. These rounds were designed for high muzzle velocity and strong penetration. The 128mm caliber gave the Maus the ability to destroy any Allied tank at long ranges. Although only two were built, the sheer caliber of its gun made it a formidable design. Number 4, the Jagdtiger. The German Jagdtiger was a super heavy tank destroyer introduced in 1944. It was designed to mount the massive 128mm PAK-44 L-55 gun. The caliber of 128mm provided it with unmatched anti-tank firepower in World War II. It also fired projectiles weighing about 28 to 28.3 kilograms for both armor-piercing and high-explosive types. With this weapon, the Jagdtiger could destroy any Allied tank from long distances, often before the enemy could return fire. Around 700 to 88 vehicles were produced, making it the most heavily armed AFV to see actual combat service in World War II. Despite its firepower, the Jagdtiger was plagued by reliability issues due to its extreme weight and mechanical strain. Still, in direct combat, its gun was feared and respected. Number 3, the KV-2. The Soviet KV-2 was a heavy tank developed in 1940 as a part of the Kliment Voroshilov series. Its design featured a massive boxer turret to mount the 152mm M10 howitzer. It used separate loading ammunition, and individual projectiles are generally listed at about 40 kilograms, while a complete cartridge is often sighted around 51.5 kilograms. Typical rounds included high explosive fragmentation and specialized anti-fortification projectiles. The caliber of 152mm was intended to break through Finnish bunkers during the Winter War. This gave the KV-2 enormous firepower compared to other tanks of its time. However, the heavy gun and oversized turret made the vehicle slow, unstable, and difficult to operate. Despite its flaws, the 152mm gun could destroy any German tank in 1941. The KV-2 saw limited service, mostly during the early stages of World War II. Even so, its 152mm caliber gun secured its place as one of the largest tank-mounted weapons ever fielded. At number 2, the American M551 ARAAV. The American M551 Sheridan was a light tank introduced in 1969. Its primary weapon was the 152mm M81 gun launcher, an unusually large caliber for such a light vehicle. The M81 gun was capable of firing both conventional 152mm ammunition and the MGM-51 shellac missile. Its conventional projectiles were comparatively light for the caliber, with the heat round weighing about 18.9 kilograms to 22 kilograms, while the shellac missile itself weighed roughly 27.8 kilograms. When assembled as complete fixed cartridges with propellant and combustible cases, the conventional rounds reached a total weight of around 49 to 50 kilograms. The 152mm caliber gave the Sheridan unique destructive potential, though it came with drawbacks. Its recoil and ammunition storage limited its effectiveness in sustained combat. Nevertheless, Sheridan served extensively in Vietnam and later the Cold War. The Sheridan thus stands out as one of the few Western tanks armed with a weapon exceeding 120mm caliber. Number 1. The T-30 Heavy Tank. The American T-30 heavy tank was developed during the World War II, but completed after the war. It entered service in April of 1945. Unlike many experimental designs, it was built in small numbers and entered limited service. Its main weapon was a massive 155mm T-7 gun, making it the largest calibers ever mounted on a tank. This gun was adapted from American heavy artillery, intended to destroy enemy fortifications and tanks alike. The weight of the shell was 43 kilograms and the charge 18 kilograms, a total of 61 kilograms or 134 pounds for the whole round, which made it difficult to handle and gave it a rate of fire of only 2 rounds per minute when manually loaded. The T-30 was too heavy and impractical for mass production, but it demonstrated the extreme upper limit of tank armament. Its 155mm caliber was unique in Western tank development, and while not widely fielded, it remains part of the lineage of American heavy tank experiments. There's one notable mention that deserves attention here, the Sturm Tiger. This was not a main battle tank or a tank destroyer, but rather a heavy assault gun built on the chassis of the Tiger 1, or the Tiger 1. Its main armament was the enormous 380mm Raketenwerfer 61 L5.4, a breech-loading barrel that fired short-range, rocket-propelled projectiles measuring roughly 1.5 meter in length. These shells came in several types, weighing up to 367 kilograms or 829 pounds, with a maximum range of about 6,000 meters or 20,000 feet. Some carried a massive high explosive charge of 125 kilograms or 276 pounds, while others were shaped chargers capable of penetrating up to 2.5 meters, 8 feet, 2 inches of reinforced concrete. Such firepower enabled the Sturm Tiger to demolish bunkers, bring down entire buildings, and clear fortified urban areas with a single devastating hit. Its short barrel gave the gun a distinctive stubby appearance, yet its destructive effort was unmatched, making it more of a siege weapon than a conventional battlefield tank. However, this overwhelming armament also brought significant challenges, as the vehicle could only carry a limited supply of the enormous shells, each of which required special loading equipment due to their immense size and weight. Well, that's it guys for today. We hope you've enjoyed today's video, and if you did, don't forget to hit that notification and subscription button, and we'll bring you more updated and interesting videos from the world of military. We'll see you guys again in our next video. Stay tuned guys, bye-bye.